Hey there, welcome back to our Power Platform tutorial series. I'm Tiyani. Today we will show you an essential process on deploying solutions seamlessly across environments using pipelines in Power Platform. This is a game changer to reduce the time you spend on exporting solutions from one environment, ensuring the solution is working fine using the solution checker, and then importing it into the target environment. This process we are showing you will simplify your life. But before we dive into this exciting adventure, do me a solid, hit that subscribe button, give us a thumbs up, and please leave a comment down in the comment section below. We appreciate your support. Open the Power Platform Maker portal. Click on the Power Platform on the sitemap and choose Power Platform Admin Center. Once it's loaded, expand Resources and click Dynamics 365 Apps. Give it a couple of seconds to load. Search for Power Platform Pipelines. Select it and click the install button. On the side pane, select the environment where you want to install it. Agree on the terms and click install. It takes a couple of minutes to install, so give it some time to finish. Great, now it's installed. Go back to the Power Platform environment. Under your apps, you will see the Deployment Pipeline Configuration app. Open the app and authenticate to the app. When it's loaded, you will see an empty dashboard. This is because we haven't configured anything in there. Let's open a new Notepad tab. We are going to copy some data that we are going to use to configure the pipelines. We need to configure dev and its environment ID. The same goes for QA and production, and their names too. Go to the Power Platform Admin Center and navigate to the environments. Select the environment and copy the environment ID. Notice the environment ID has a prefix of default. I'm not going to copy this, and you'll see in just a minute why. Let's finish up the copying process for the other environments. I'm just copying the QA environment ID. And lastly, the production environment ID. Now, using this information, let's go back to our deployment pipeline configuration app and start the configuration process for our environment. Click on Environments. New to start creating, give your environment a name. Choose the appropriate environment type. Paste the ID you've just copied from Notepad and click on Save and Close. Be mindful of the validation status. As you can see, it's pending. It will change once it's done. This should fail, and I will explain why. Remember the environment ID we copied with a prefix of default? That's the reason it's failing. It needs that exact ID as you saw in the environment. Go back to the Power Platform Admin Center and copy the environment ID as correctly displayed. Once done, go back to the Deployment Pipeline Configuration app. When we open the record, it shows the error as I have just explained. Unfortunately, once the record is created, you cannot edit the ID. Let's delete it. Then recreate it with the correct details. Click Save and Close. And let's monitor the validation status. Refresh, and there we go. It's now a success. Let's create another for QA. Give it a nice name. Type now should be target environment and paste the ID we copied for it. Save and close. This should also fail on validation. Here's the reason for the failure in the error message. The environment is not sitting in the same geographical location. Let's go and configure the environments in the same geolocation. We will go with QA and production as they are in the same geolocation. Let's go through the same process for the QA deployment environment. Set it as the development environment. Click Save and Close. Great, it passed the validation. Now let's do prod deployment environment. Set it as the target environment. Click save and close. And as you can see, it also passes the validation. Now that both have passed, it's time to configure our pipelines. Click on pipelines. New, we are going to call this one QA to prod. And click on save, not save and close. Let's add the deployment environment we created earlier to our pipeline. After this, we need to create a deployment state. Add a meaningful name. And choose the prod target deployment environment. We will leave out the previous deployment state since we don't have a dev environment. And click save. Mind the validation status on linked environments. Let us go to the Power Platform portal and create a solution. I actually forgot this is a new environment. Let's create a new publisher. Save. Choose our new publisher. Give it a name. And click create. Let's add a new table called room. Add a new column called room number. And customize the form a little by adding the room number and status reason. Now we're done with the components. On the sitemap, select pipelines. Notice the pipeline dropdown has our QA to prod pipeline selected, and that is the only one we have in our environment. Go ahead and click on deploy here. It's going to ask you a couple of things, giving us the opportunity to run the pipeline now or schedule it for later date and time. But for the demo, we want to run it now. Click next. It will start validating our deployment solution. And once done, it will tell us we are clear to start deployment. Let's click deploy to start our deployment process. This will check the source solution, publish it, export it, import it to the target environment, and publish it for us. This process does take a few minutes, but it will save you the hassle of doing all those tasks manually. While it's busy, you can go to the deployment pipeline app to monitor the process from there too. Our dashboard now has data on the visuals. Click on Run History to see more detailed records of our deployment process. We can see it's still deploying. If you go to Solution Artifact, you will see the record for our deployment showing us the zip managed solution in the target environment. And later on, we will be able to see the zip unmanaged solution from the source environment. Let's go back to Power Platform and wait for it to finish deploying. Great, it's done deploying and without errors. Let's go back just to see what our solution artifacts are looking like after the deployment is completed. You see now the unmanaged artifact is now populated. You can also see the details of the deployment process in the deployment information tab. In the Power Platform portal, go to the target or production environment to see the deployed solution. Remember, the deployed solution is managed, so click on the Manage tab to see it, and there it is. Let's open it and inspect the artifact. Everything seems to be there as expected. Just a note, if a member of your team can't see the pipeline, we need to go to Power Platform Admin Center. On environment under users, click select all. Select the user you want to give the roles to. Click manage security role. Look for deployment pipeline administrator, deployment pipeline default, and deployment pipeline user. Select those roles to give the user the appropriate roles to perform tasks using our pipeline and click save. And now it's done. They should be able to see and deploy using our pipeline. And there you have it. In today's tutorial, we took you through a step-by-step guide on installing the pipeline app, configuring it, using pipelines in Power Platform, and assigning roles to users who will be deploying using pipeline. If you found this tutorial as exciting as we did, give us a virtual high five, hit that like button, and hey, if you're hungry for more thrilling content, don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Thank you for tuning in. See you in the next one.